An Australian Christmas is unique in many ways, and this time of year usually conjures up images of tropical summer storms, bikinis on beaches, surfing Santas, mozzies, and, of course, Christmas beetles.
Yeah, but have you noticed over the last few years that those beetles, they've been hard to find?
Yes.
Well, our scientists had too. And now they're asking for your help to figure out where they've all gone.
Associate Professor Tanya Laddie is an entomologist at the School of Life and Environmental Sciences at the University of Sydney. And she's heading up a program and she's joining us now on the couch. Hello, lovely to see you.
Good morning.
What's happening here with our Christmas beetles? Is climate change to blame?
We don't know, and that's really the scary thing. I mean, our big suspect is probably habitat loss. So baby Christmas beetles are these big chonky grubs that live in the soil, mm-hmm. and they feed on the roots of native grasses. Unfortunately, we've had such high rates of land clearing that we've lost a lot of the open woodland that had that grass. If you don't have the grass, you don't have the baby beetles. If you don't have the baby beetles, you don't have, you know, Christmas beetles in the Christmas time. But that's only one possibility. It could also be climate change. Pesticide overuse and misuse could also be contributing. We don't have the data, and that's the real problem.
Oh. Yeah, so what is the issue with getting all that data? Because you don't think they're extinct yet, which is good news.
Yeah, so there's actually 35 different types of Christmas beetles, so 35 species. And it's entirely possible that some have declined while others are doing fine. We just don't know. And, you know, I'm originally from Canada, and when I arrived in Australia 15 years ago, people kept telling me these, frankly, quite fantastical stories of how Christmas in Australia was heralded by the arrival of these beautiful, glittery beetles, and I was so excited to see that. But in that 15 years, I've seen Christmas beetles maybe a handful of times. There's clearly something has changed. Anytime I talk to anyone over 25, they tell me about these memories. And if it was one person, well, that, you know, memory's fallible, that's one thing. But when you see that many people with the same memory and now it's not happening, that makes me worry.
I thought the Christmas beetles might have been different in Sydney, and I tried to pick up a big black one. It was a rhinoceros beetle. It started hissing at me and trying to bite me. They're angry.
They are.
Very angry Christmas beetles. They're not Christmas beetles at all. You've called on the community to help you. What would you like us to do?
We desperately need people to go out, and if they see a Christmas beetle, take a picture of it and upload it to a website called iNaturalist. The iNaturalist is a website, and it's also an app. The awesome thing about the app is that once you take that picture, the algorithm will try to identify what you've taken a picture of.
Uh-huh.
And it's not just Christmas beetles. It'll work for any kind of life. So if you have a mystery plant or a mystery insect, it will identify it. And once you upload it to this global database, that information goes into our project. So every time anybody submits a sighting of a Christmas beetle, we'll get to see it. And that will start to help us figure out, you know, are there particular species of Christmas beetle that are in trouble? Are there particular regions that have had bigger declines? And once we know that, we can start thinking about what we need to do to conserve them.
Oh, great. So give us a couple of tips then, because my kids will love this. I mean, where should we go to find them? What time of the day? What do they look like? I don't think I had them.
They have little tiny little Santa hats, yeah.
Well, as far as how to tell them apart from other beetles, they do look a lot like other scarabs, which are in the same group. But again, that's not a problem. Still take the picture and upload it because the algorithm will do the heavy lifting for you. And we have a team of experts going through all the records to find the ones that are actually Christmas beetles. So don't worry too much. Christmas beetles are usually large and kind of iridescent, but not always. They often have a little bit of a duck bill on the front, and they have quite thick rear legs compared to other scarabs. So those are some tips.
That's the Christmas party.
A tiny little duck.
Well, that's mostly what they're doing this time of year. They're coming out.
Maybe that's what their privacy. Who knows? Yeah. Tanya, thank you so much for coming in. This is such a good thing for the community to get involved in, particularly around Christmas time. We'll put all the details on our socials. Thanks again.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.